for the family, because family, especially extended family, had a number of governors, senators, members of cabinet. We used to dominate our province before 1948. So that was my father and high of story. So, when I brought to exclusive school run by the Jesuits in Manila, run by American Jesuits, I had the shock of my life when the hero that was revealed in my uniform was considered a thug, a gangster from the Portland district of Ondo. So, and then a senator was very anti-imperialist, denouncing America domination and the U.S. federal races, was called a crazy communist. So I thought, that would be something good. Communist. That's how I became interested. I looked for books on communism. I couldn't find one. What I found was a book, a doctoral dissertation in Fordham by a scholar, by someone called Charles McFadden. And he quoted, he dealt with the philosophy of Christianity and Marxism, but I made a mistake. And I became more impressed with the quotation from Martin Engels and from the Bible and you know, from St. Thomas Aquinas and so on and so forth. So, then you see I had influences from real life. So aside from, you know, what experience in school, about then, we not earning enough from our side, so they go to Central Luzon. Central Luzon was in my younger days, the revolutionary movement was going on, and among themselves, we hear them talking about land reform promised revolutionary movement, and against landlords. It was different when they were in my home, they would talk in a way pleasing to parents, but outside, you know, and then my classmates would say their great-grandparents and grandparents were cheated of their land by my great-father. So I got those stories, and I was influenced by that. You know? I didn't like hearing such stories, but obviously, how can a man accumulate so much land, you know, if not some special means out of land and producing more than enough to buy more land. So, and then when I was sent to Manila to study school, we had an apartment to a working class area, and I observed the life of the workers. I also saw strikes going on, you know, the Jesuits were trying to supplant communism in the great movement. I even sold newspaper from the Reform Trade Union Organization, set up by the church, boys setting up the trade movement for the workers. So I became aware of that. But you know, I was really joking by, you know, remarks against one Andres Bonifacio and Claudio Recto. I thought, American Jesuits are not telling the students the truth. So when I went to the University of the Philippines, State University, you know, I was eager to move from the Catholic school, high school, to the public school again, I retained this spirit of being sympathetic to working people, to the toiling masses of workers and peasants. And I matured as a progressive liberal only in 1958, and by maturation, I mean, you know, knowing the ideas well enough, I was lucky to be at the university when professors were doing a lot of research publishing their books on the revolution of 1896. They were presenting Philippine history, not the colonial view, but from the view of the Filipino people, and they were presenting the political ideas and constitutional ideas of the revolution. I benefited from a reading of these. During the same period, I read a publication which was postponing and the peasant war in the Philippines. It presented the problems of the Philippine peasantry and become the target of an anti-communist witch hunt. And then, I must learn a lot from reading materials that I was writing articles previously in the school newspaper. And I wrote some under my name and others under the pseudonym. The most dedicated had to be under the pseudonym with those criticizing U.S. Imperial power. And one of the articles in praise of Patrice Lumumba, that's how nationalist I was, Patrice Lumumba of Congo, wrote an article that was the subject of which it became one of the articles which was targeted by the committee on anti-Filipino activities, the committee on un-American activities, it's an anti-communist committee. Anyway, let me now start to discuss how I began co-founding and organizing organizations that would lead to development of revolutionary movement in the Philippines. The students, and of course the priests, were dominant in Philippine politics, in the campus, on the campus part politics. So the gathering of the Catholic Action Group was Scout. So we formed Scout, no? You see, we live on the surface not only to invoke academic freedom and fight for the democratic rights of the faculty members, students, and researchers, but also to raise the level of political debate on the campus. The level of political debate was one between progressive liberalism religious theory, terms, no? That was the conflict. So we said, let's do something about raising the level of debate, one between the left and the right, no? So we thought that we could put forward Marxism and started with it way, and we have united from the progressive liberals in the university in order to face up to the Catholic Italian political group. And in the SCAR, we had two levels of education. One level was the other one. Education for continuance of the Philippine Revolution of 1896 under the terms of